that.
My video today is going to be different from what you have been seeing frequently. It is going to be all about how you need to behave during this time, during the time of crisis. What we do today is going to depend how our future is going to be. So let us not panic. Let us take the maximum use of our time. Let us work on our skills. Let us think out of the box. Ram took a large sum of money from Raj, who was aged and unattractive, wherein Raj had a fancy for Ram's daughter. So Raj thought of a cunning trick. He told Ram that he will give him an option by which he would be able to free himself from all the debt. So he said he will take two pebbles in his hand, a black and a white. If his daughter chooses the white one, he would be free from all the debt. But if she chooses the black one, he will be free from the debt, but the daughter will have to marry him. Ram had no other option but to go ahead with it. As we know, Raj had something cunning in his mind. While picking up the pebbles, he picked up both black pebbles in his hand. The daughter saw it secretly. Now, she had two options. The first one was to not agree with what was going on, and the second one was to sacrifice her life to free her father from the debt. But she took some time. She thought out of the box, and hence she reached to a solution. She told Raj that she is fine with it, but the hand she chooses, Raj will have to give that pebble in her hand, and she would open it and see what the color is, to which Raj agreed. So she chose a hand, Raj gave the pebble in her hand, and she purposely dropped the pebble. The pebble fell on the ground and it got mixed with other pebbles. And she said, "Oh, how clumsy of me. I dropped the pebble. I am so sorry. But what to do now?" So she said, "Raj, let us check the pebble in your hand. I am sure the other would be in my hand." And this is how she found a solution for herself. Hence, we too, in this situation of crisis, let us find an opportunity in this challenge. I have 10 tips for you as to how to use your time constructively in this house arrest for the next 21 days. So here comes tip number 1. There would have been people in your life who would have contributed in making you. They have contributed in making what you are today, and I am sure you would not have got enough time to show gratitude towards them, to thank them out. So pick up those 5 people from your life, send them thank you, send them a message saying that you are thankful for whatever they are today. Tip number 2. It is said that reading books is one of the best hobby you can ever have, and if you read 3 books on one single topic, you can be an expert on that topic. So just grill on with your skills. Where are you lacking back? What are those skills that are missing? What are those things that are pulling you behind in moving ahead? Find those out and read 3 books on them. For all those who are a little lazy, for all those who do not like to read books, these days we have audiobooks available as well. You get many free audiobooks on YouTube. We have many other apps. One of them is Storytel. You can just go on them and listen to the books. Tip number 3 is clear your desktops, your mails, do backups, organize and arrange your photos. There are many ways which are available online how you can do them the best. Tip number 4, I am sure you would have had a hobby or a passion which you were not able to pursue because of lack of time, because of lack of priority. So this is the right time wherein you can start. I am sure in these 21 days, maybe you may not reach where you want to, but at least you will start. Tip number 5 is for all the students out there. There are many online courses available, and let me tell you, all the universities, the Harvard, the Stanford, they all have launched free online courses. Why don't you take the best use of it? There are many other apps as well, Udemy, Coursera, which offer you very cheap courses. Don't waste your time and upgrade your skills, your knowledge by doing those courses. I am doing few of them. Tip number 6, all those busy parents who have not been able to give time to their toddlers, to their children, this is the right time. Tell them lots of stories, play games with them. I'll be attaching few links wherein with the video, so you will be able to find out the activities. So do lots of activities, take them with you in the kitchen and they will help you cook, and believe me, they will have a gala time, they'll really enjoy. Work on your finances and investment. This is the right time to invest in the market. So you can do Skype interviews with financial advisors, talk to them, drill all your finances, see the best option and work on them. Tip number 8 for all those housewives and the working women: declutter your house, do a deep cleaning, and I'm sure you will be, that ways you will be able to have a lot more time during Diwali. Tip number 9, you can make different gravies and deep freeze them. You can freeze the peas, you can freeze mango pulp, which are available when you have a short of time. And last but not the least, tip number 10, make a health goal. So we all have some issues. Maybe you have a migraine, or you have a knee pain, or you have a hair loss, or maybe you want to work on your eyes, or anything. So this is the right time wherein you can start with it. There are many videos and options available. There are many home remedies available online, yogas available. Please do that, so that at least those things can be taken care of during this time of crisis. Remember, there is always a new beginning. A seed when comes out from a fruit or vegetable which is dead, it gives life. A volcano when erupts, it gives a fertile soil. So we should not lose hope. We should not lose faith. Let us all be positive and do our best. I would end up this video by giving gratitude to all those who are working 24/7 for us so that we can be safe, the doctors, the nurses, the policemen and others. I end up my video here. Do share it with your friends and relatives once again. Thank you for now. See you all.